Hey guys, today we're checking out the ATI FireGL T264. AGP video cards are getting a little bit harder to find and more expensive, but this one is still quite cheap. If you type FireGL T2 into eBay, there is a listing at the moment for $599 US and then around $8 and so on. So these go for very little at the moment. The other interesting thing is this is a low profile video card. So if you've got a small form factor machine, this might be of interest to you. And finally, this is a workstation video card. Now we had a look at some NVIDIA Quadro graphics cards in the past for the purpose of getting them cheaper compared to a GeForce. And we found that under Direct3D, the performance is equivalent to the GeForce's, but under OpenGL, the performance is a little bit behind. Now we also had a look at one FireGL card from ATI, that was the 8800, which is basically the workstation equivalent of the Radeon 8500. And that card was a little bit of a disaster. Under Direct3D, everything worked fine, but with OpenGL, there were a ton of driver issues. So that is one of the things that we will be looking at in this video. So in this video, we will be answering a couple of questions. We will go over the specifications, but we will also find a Radeon card, overclock it to the same clocks as this one, and see if the performance is identical. We will also have a look at the drivers and can you use standard Radeon drivers and not just the workstation drivers. We will also check out performance under Windows 9.8. We will then move on to Windows XP, and we've got quite a few gameplay footage. For example, Far Cry, Half-Life 2, Portal, Doom 3, and more. Basically to see what this card can do. And at the end, is this card worth getting? So the ATI FireGL T2 is from 2003, and it's got the RV350 GPU. Now that is the same GPU as the Radeon 9600 cards, and basically they are half of the R300 GPU, which is from the Radeon 9700. But it is produced on a slightly smaller process, and so it's quite power efficient. Even the 9600 Pro gets away without an external power connector. We have 4 pixel pipelines, there's a 128-bit memory interface. Unfortunately, the VRAM is only 64 megabyte, which is half of what you usually get. Now, although this card was quite cheap, there are a few extras that you need to purchase. One of them is you need a breakout cable. So the connector on here is not your standard DVI port. This is a low force Helix 60 pin connector, and you need some breakout cables. Also, the bracket is low profile, so if you're using this in a normal case, you also have to source a replacement bracket. So let's have a look at these breakout cables. I've got one here for analog, so you just plug that into your video card. And these are labeled. We've got a number 2 here, and that one is labeled number 1 on the other side. And I've also got one for DVI, so 60 pin connector on this end. And then we've got 2 DVI ports for here. Now I did run into an interesting technical issue with this breakout cable, and we will get to that shortly. But now let's have a look at the experience under Windows 98. I've recently upgraded my AGP test system. You can find the specifications down below in the description. Between Windows 98 and Windows XP, the memory is different, 512 compared to 2 gigabytes, and also the hard drive. I'm using an 80 gigabyte hard drive for 98 and a 500 gigabyte for Windows XP. So when I went to the AMD website to have a look at the drivers, I was quite surprised that Windows 98 is not supported. We only get drivers for 2000, XP, Vista, and also Windows 7. So the next best thing I did, I tried these Omega drivers. They are available for Windows 98, but without any luck, they wouldn't pick up a compatible video card. So the next step was I downloaded the latest drivers for the Radeon 9600, and I ran the installer, which then unpacks the files to the hard drive under C/ATI. And then you can go to the device manager and you can manually install the driver and pick the device. So I just went with a generic 9600 series driver, and that worked fine. Now this will give you the driver. It won't give you the control panel, but you just go into a subdirectory within C/ATI. and that's where you can install the control panel. And after that, I had all the options and I ran Dark 3D games as well as OpenGL games, and all the games worked just fine. But then I ran into a weird issue. In 3DMark, I was getting this corrupt pixels, and usually that's a sign of a failing card. However, I've already tried the card under Windows XP and I had no issues. Also, I swapped out a Radeon 9550 and that card also worked. And so I mucked around with some options. There are some options for the DVI connection in the driver, and also used a tool to lock the refresh rate to 60 Hz, and now the issue went away. And I think what happened is that the refresh rate was really high, around 200 Hz by default, and that the DVI breakout cable simply couldn't handle that high bandwidth, and it would get just digital data would get corrupted, and that's why we saw pixels on the screen. So if you're running into the same issue, have a look at your refresh rate. Maybe it's too high, and also play around with these DVI options in the driver. Maybe they fix your problem. Now, because I also wanted to check out Windows XP in this video and some gameplay, we didn't have much time to run benchmarks under Windows 98, but we have three benchmarks here. The first one is Draken with Maximum Details, so that's a direct 3D game, and you can see really good performance. So we have some resolution scaling going on here from 640 by 480 all the way up to 1600 by 1200. And moving on to the next game, this is OpenGL. We've got Quake 3 with the high quality preset. Also really high frames up to 1600 by 1200, getting 79 FPS. And then we've got MDK 2. That game, the 1600 by 1200 resolution, it just wouldn't work, but we're getting similar performance at 1280 by 1024. So the bottom line is that this video card is excellent for Windows 98. You should be able to play pretty much any game at high details and high resolutions. So under Windows XP, we didn't have to force any drivers. We have official FireGL drivers and they work just fine. They install the Catalyst Control Center as well. So you get all the relevant gaming options as well, like anti-aliasing, anisotropic filtering, VSync and all of that. And I had no issues with running OpenGL games and Direct3D games. So now I wanted to know, does the FireGL operate at the same level of performance compared to a Radeon? So I used a Radeon 9550, but the core clock was lower, so I overclocked the card to match the clocks of the FireGL, and then I ran some benchmarks. I also had a look for a similar driver version for the Radeon, so that they're not too far apart. So let's have a look at some results. First up, we've got Far Cry running at high details, and we've got some resolution scaling going on here. And you can see, basically, they're on the same level. Yes, there might be a difference of like FPS or two, but that could be because the Radeon 9550 actually has 256 megabyte of VRAM, so that could definitely be a difference. I also had a look at OpenGL. That's the more interesting test. So here we have Doom 3, and we got two settings. The first one is 640 by 480 with low details, and the second is 800 by 600 with medium details, and look at that. They perform at the same level. So that's awesome. That's a lot better than with the FireGL 8800, where OpenGL performance was terrible and we couldn't find a driver that actually made it work properly. With the FireGL T2, yes, it performs just as well as a Radeon. So that definitely opens a few doors for us. If you're looking for a cheap AGP video card, have a look for the ATI FireGL cards. Throughout the video and also now in the background is some gameplay footage, so that's under Windows XP. All the games are running at 1024 by 768. And because the video card only has 64 meg of VRAM, in most games that have an option to auto detect the optimal settings, I just went with that and then changed the resolution. And yeah, we can kind of see that the games do run okay. But the 64 megabyte of VRAM is definitely hurting. In Doom 3, for example, it defaults to low details, and in Half-Life 2, it picks the low resolution textures as well. So that's a shame. 128 megabytes of memory would have been a lot better. And it's clocked lower with the passive cooling. And yeah, so I think it's time to wrap up this video and share my thoughts. So the good thing, definitely this is a cheap card. I think I got it for $8. So for an HP video card, that's not too bad. However, you have to spend a bit extra money to get the breakout cable and then also a fitting bracket to fit it into a full ATX case. And unfortunately, only 64 megabytes of VRAM, and we had some issues with the Windows 9 Air drivers. We have to force some Radeon drivers. It's not a big deal, but it could be a lot easier compared to Windows XP, for example. It was very straightforward. But we also learned that the Fire GL video cards seem to perform identical to the Radeon, so that's very interesting. I will definitely try to pick up a few more Fire GL video cards. Now, if you like the T2 series, there is a faster model. It's called the Fire GL T2-128, and that addresses a lot of the shortcomings. It's got a regular DVI output, it's got 128 megabyte of VRAM, a fan which points to higher clock speeds, and that's a card I definitely plan on looking at in the near future. And of course, this is a low profile AGP video card, and I don't think there are too many around, so that might make this video card interesting if you're building a small form factor project. Now, finally, if you're considering this card, the price has to be right, because firstly, you need to spend more for the breakout cable, but also you can just buy a Radeon 9600 or 9600 Pro or XT, and they don't cost too much more, maybe $20 or $30, depending on what's available on eBay at the moment. And that's it for this video. I'm looking forward to testing more Fire GL video cards, now seeing that they perform on the same level as a Radeon. But do let me know what you think and what would you like to see with these video cards. Also, if you enjoyed the video and you want to see more stuff like it, why not subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already? Click on that notification bell, because subscribing is not enough, and hit that like button. Thank you for watching, and I shall see you soon with another one.